Nowadays, modern day cameras are basically computers with image sensors built in. So sometimes this computer will crash, or something will fail, or something will get corrupted within the programming. Most of the time, if you take the battery out and put it back in, or just turn the camera off and on again, it sorts out the situation. But every now and then, there'll be an issue that needs a little bit more work than this. So if there's a function that's not working properly on your camera, and it doesn't matter whether you turn it off and on again, it just seems to still be there, try this. Take the battery out. Leave it for 5 minutes without the battery. Then once you replace the battery, reset to default settings after reinstalling the battery. After doing the factory reset, you will have to set up your camera properly. So maybe before you do the factory reset, make a note of all the settings, all of your custom menu buttons and things like that, so then you can quickly set them up again. If you haven't done this and you've done a factory reset, click on the eye in the corner or the link in the description to my How to Set Your A7 III Up for Photography. This will show you how I set it up, and it'll show you where all of the preset buttons that I use are. Taking the battery out of the camera and leaving it for 5 minutes is almost like unplugging and replugging in your computer. So it kind of resets the brains of the camera, and then if you reset to factory settings, that gets everything back to where it should be when they first manufactured the camera. Hopefully, this will sort out any problems you have with your camera. If not, it would probably be advisable to get in contact with Sony. I don't have any affiliations with Sony, I just use their cameras, and I want to know how they work and the best way to get around any problems that I have with them. Thanks to the YouTuber Robito for giving me this information. Robito had an issue with bright monitoring not working, and he just couldn't get it to work properly. So he contacted Sony, and they told him to take these steps. Once the camera was reset after going through these steps, bright monitoring started working properly again. Thanks, Robito, for that information. It's great to have it, and I just thought I'd make this little video giving this information to everyone who needed it. For more videos, subscribe and make sure you click the notification bell. Also, head over to my YouTube channel where I have a growing library of photography and videography tutorials. I'll see you next time.